I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Winter Haven. I'm Sydney, and you're watching BDTV for Tuesday, March 26, 2024. March is Women's History Month. This month, we'll be celebrating by announcing an important figure on BDTV every day. Today, we'll be highlighting Anna Eleanor Roosevelt. Eleanor Roosevelt was an American political figure, diplomat, and activist. She was the First Lady of the United States from 1933 to 1945 during her husband President Franklin D. Roosevelt's four terms, making her the longest serving First Lady of the United States. She served as a U.S. delegate in the UN General Assembly and took a leading role in designing the text of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Coming up on today's show is Marine Science and the Laws of Motion.
You my little boo thing, so I'll give a hoot what you do, say girl, I know, you a little too tame, I'll be shooting that shot like 2K, girl, I know, tell him I'm next, tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know, tell him I'm next, tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know, put a little gold in the teeth and the fit good, so I took the doors out the deep, okay, I see a brother holding your seat, no beef, but I'm trying to get the noise, you at least don't take my talking to your own, I can keep it chill like the Soviet Union blunt, I'ma keep it.
I'm Kelly.
And I'm Jess.
Let's get into the announcements.
Students, remember to check your email every day. You may receive important news through your school email.
The Mid-March Scholarship Bulletin is out now. Check out these in the guidance office.
There are volunteer opportunities on the Guidance Department's Community Service Bulletin Board. Check these out for community service hours.
Winter Haven will have a blood drive on April 3rd. Sign up during lunches in the cafeteria on April 1st and 2nd. To donate, you must be at least 16 years old with parent permission and weigh at least 100 pounds. Be sure to drink lots of water 2 days prior to donation. Avoid caffeinated drinks and to eat breakfast that morning.
Polk State College is having their open house today, March 26th from 5 to 7, and the Lakeland campus on April 4th from 5 to 7. Open enrollment for summer starts April 8th, and open enrollment for fall starts June 3rd.
Each spring, ODT of the Box Improv invites local theater students to workshop and perform expert improvisers as part of an improv masterclass. This year, the following Blue Devil Drama students will participate in the annual OTB Student Showcase: Tessa Klein, Kit McGuire, Nadia Roberts, Sophia Thornhill, and Maya Twyford.
Let's go to Ari for all the sports this week.
Hey, Winter Haven. There are a lot of athletic events coming up this week. On Tuesday, flag football will play at 7 at Lake Gibson. Baseball will play at home against Lake Gibson. JV at 5, varsity at 7:30. Boys lacrosse will play at 7 at home against Tampa Prep. At 3, boys and girls tennis will play at George Jenkins. And last but not least, softball will play at Bartow, JV at 5:30, varsity at 7:30. On Wednesday, JV baseball will play at 7 at George Jenkins. Beach volleyball will play at 3:30 and 4:30 at Polk State College. On Thursday, softball will play at home against Lake Wales, JV at 5:30, varsity at 7:30. Boys and girls tennis will play at 3:30 at the Winter Haven courts. Boys volleyball will be at 7 at Ridgecrest. Also on Thursday, boys volleyball will play at 6:30 at home. Flag football will be at 7, also at home. Varsity baseball will play at 7 at McKeel. JV baseball will play at 7 at LCS. On Friday, softball will play at Armondale, JV at 5:30, varsity at 7:30. Boys lacrosse will play at 7 at home against Newark Academy. Also on Friday, girls lacrosse will play at 7 at Lakeland. Varsity baseball will play at 7:30 at home, and the track and field will have a meet at UF. And don't forget about the Saturday athletic events. Track and field will have a meet at UF. Sophomore and freshman county championships will be at 8 a.m. at Lake Region, and boys weightlifting will have their districts at 10 a.m. at Ridgecrest. I hope to see you there.
Thanks, Ari.
The annual OTB Student Showcase will be held at the Ritz Theater on Friday, March 29th at 7 p.m. For more information, please see the flyer below. All proceeds from this performance will benefit the Ritz. If you see these students, please tell them to break a leg, and I hope you'll be able to join them at the showcase.
On Saturday, March 23rd, our drill team went to the Area 12 District Drill Meet. Our female armed and unarmed squads, as well as our male mixed color guard, placed third overall. Then our female color guard placed second overall. These four teams have earned the opportunity to compete at the state drill meet on April 6th.
Seniors, Thursday, April 18th, there will be a graduation meeting in the auditorium beginning immediately after seniors check in with their third period teachers. You will need to bring your book bags and a writing utensil. Important information regarding graduation will be discussed. After the meeting, seniors will be released to the cafeteria to receive their caps and gowns.
You must be present to receive your cap and gown. If you aren't present on that day, the gowns will be locked up in the main office and will be available for pickup before school or during fifth period only. Senior teachers are expected to attend the meeting as this is a very large class and your help is needed.
Let's go to Eteria to learn more about marine science.
The ocean covers about 71% of our Earth's surface, so it's not surprising that it plays a huge role in our environment. The ocean can impact our temperatures, the Earth's atmosphere, and it is also home to a multitude of marine species. I'm Eteria with BDTV, and let's learn more about our oceans and marine life. The ocean also helps our atmosphere because of its plant life. The plants that live in the ocean absorb carbon dioxide so that they can carry out photosynthesis, just like the plants on land. The ocean actually plays a large role in removing most of the carbon dioxide that is in our atmosphere. The ocean also plays a part in our temperature by soaking up energy in the form of heat and evenly distributing it across the planet. Did you know that an estimated 50 to 80% of all life on Earth is found under the ocean surface? It is said that less than 10% of the oceans have been explored by humans. Currently, scientists have named and classified around 1.5 million species, though it's predicted that there may be way more. Now, I may have mentioned that the ocean has a lot of different species, but did you know that the blue whale is the largest animal in the ocean? Speaking of sea animals, Ms. Garcia's ACE Environmental Management class and Ms. Archambault's ACE Marine Science class went on a field trip to SeaWorld Orlando to learn more about marine species and their conservation efforts. Let's see how their trip went. Wow, that must have been an amazing experience. Florida is so lucky because we're surrounded by water since we're a peninsula, and we even have SeaWorld in Orlando. So go out and learn more about our ocean and marine life, Winter Haven.
Thanks, Eteria.
I'm going to the Dutch Exchange after sessions, and so should you. If you're interested in hosting a student from the Netherlands or having an opportunity to travel to the Netherlands and Paris, then attend one of the two Dutch Exchange Program information sessions. Their sessions will be on April 9th and the 23rd after school in room 35-212. If you have any questions, email Mr. Brown.
Congratulations to the following students who won awards for the Ride Art Association Young Artist Show. First place, Emery Kemp with Raymond. Third place, Fiona Chen with Bamboo Vase, an award of excellence. Adriana Tapia with Patchwork Quilt. Congrats.
Attention all 11th and 12th graders. Are you interested in attending Ridge Technical College next year? There is an open house on Thursday, April 11th to explore more than 20 career and technical programs that are offered at Ridge Tech. If you're interested in going on the field trip, see Ms. Farthing in the main office to sign up and get a permission form. The deadline to sign up and have your form notarized is April 5th.
The last days to purchase Grad Bash tickets are April 1st and 2nd in Mrs. Woodhead's office. Tickets are $105, no bills larger than 20. Grad Bash will be on April 26th.
Hey Kelly, do you know the laws of motion?
All right, class, that's it for today. Homework tonight is studying the laws of motion. They will be on the physics test next class.
I am not looking forward to this test.
Yeah, what even are the laws of motion?
Who is this guy Newton anyway?
For real.
We're definitely gonna fail.
Hey, we heard you guys don't know the laws of motion?
Yeah, we don't know anything about it.
Well, we know the laws of motion.
We can show you.
It goes like this.
First you gotta know how Newton has easily shown that there's forces that act on another, creating motion, causing commotion. Let's start from the top. For the first law, bodies in motion stay in motion till a force acts upon it. This is the first law, and it goes like this. There's this thing, it's called inertia. Raises changes in motion. Now let's use this ball, and I'll show you that without friction, it will not stop rolling. That is only the first law. Come with us, you'll learn them all. We know the laws of motion. You'll learn the laws of motion. Let's learn the laws of motion. Equals MA,
but what does that mean?
It's not too obscene.
F.
It stands for force. The M stands for mass.
The A is
acceleration, multiplication. upon a mast. Take this bicycle and ride it. Pump and legs accelerate it. It will go faster. It might cause disaster. With us, you'll be a master. Now you know the second law. Remember what you just saw. We know the laws of motion. You'll know the laws of motion. Newton's laws of motion.
Wait a minute. I think I see. All these laws
deal with gravity.
Don't break a sweat. I'm a lot to get. Let's see what's next. So watch and learn. We won't show you twice. Opposite and equal, kinda like a sequel. Now you got it.
Hey, 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 hey!
And it goes like this.
Now you're ready for that test. You just learned from the best.
We know the laws of motion. No Newton's laws of motion. You know the laws of motion.
It's really not a crazy notion.
Whoa, what just happened?
We just learned the laws of motion.
I'm gonna ace this test.
Me too.
Thank you guys, now I know the laws of motion. We have three amazing students who have earned their state FFA degree, which requires over a $1,000 investment in SAE projects and worked over 300 hours outside of class time. Kylan Story, Kyrie Baldwin, and Claudia Stickland. They will receive this award at State FFA Convention in Orlando this June. In addition, we have one former Winter Haven FFA student, Kaylee Tommen, who has earned her American FFA degree, which requires over $10,000 and over 2,250 hours outside of class time. She will receive this award at the National FFA Convention in Indianapolis in October. Another congratulations to Tessa Klein, who represented Winter Haven High School last Thursday in the group level speech contest. She competed against students from Auburndale and Lake Wales. Tessa earned first place and will now compete at the district level in April. She will compete for a $1,000 scholarship. That's all we have for you today, Winter Haven. I'm Colin with BDTV. Have a great day.